At the start of the film, we see an African young lady named Aisha who is sleeping on her bed. The odd thing here is that there is water generally around her bed, and a bug is likewise creeping all over. Why it is here stays muddled. In the following scene, we discover that Aisha is an unlawful Senegalese worker in New York City. She left her now 6-year-old child, Lamin, being taken care of by her cousin, Maria, in Senegal a year sooner. She resides in a leased house and is utilized at Amy's home. Aisha is extremely cheerful, feeling that her destitution issues will end. She desires to bring in sufficient cash to bring her child and cousin as workers to the US to live with her. Aisha is employed as a babysitter for Rose, the youthful girl of Amy and Adam, a rich Upper East Side couple. On the principal day of the gig, she arrives at Amy's home. There, she is given a space to remain if she needs to go through an evening. Aside from this, Amy likewise gives her a register in which she will compose the record of her per day pay. In the wake of clearing up everything for Aisha, Amy leaves for her work, after which both eat together. Rose can do without her food, so she asks Aisha for her food and eats it. Subsequently, the two of them become excellent companions. Aisha settles on a video decision to her sister in the wake of returning home. The mine is additionally with her. Aisha joyfully lets Lamin know that she will before long call him to America. After a few days, while teaching Rose, Aisha receives a call from Amy. Amy informs her that a party is going to be held the next day to celebrate the arrival of her husband, Adam. For this, Aisha should start preparing. She makes all the necessary arrangements but is very upset because Amy has not cleared her payment for the last several days. Amy explains that she will settle all accounts after spending the night at the party. The next day, when Adam comes home from work, he doesn't look happy during the party. It becomes evident that the relationship between them is not going well. After the party, Adam calls Aisha to his cabin to pay her. He reveals that Amy had not told him about her before, which is why he is short of money now. However, he promises to make the full payment later. Judging by their behavior, it seems that both Amy and Adam are stingy. Aisha goes to sleep in her room. As soon as she closes her eyes, she starts hearing the sound of ocean waves. Suddenly, it starts raining heavily, causing Aisha to feel suffocated. Then, abruptly, she wakes up and realizes it was just a dream. The next morning, Aisha goes to the bank and transfers money for a mine. She then goes to meet her friend Sally. Here, we come to know that when Aisha was 16 years old, she was in a relationship, and she became pregnant. In any case, not long after realizing this, her sweetheart left and wedded another young lady. At the point when Aisha shows up at Amy's home, Adam requests that she go to lunch with him and Rose. Aisha, Adam, and Rose go for lunch. In the meantime, Adam's sweetheart additionally shows up, uncovering his extramarital issue. Adam leaves Rose and Aisha there and goes to spend time with his sweetheart. Afterward, she returns home with Rose. Getting back around evening time, she meets Malik, the concierge at Amy's apartment complex. Malik and Aisha trade jokes, and afterward she goes to her home. The following night, Aisha is partaking in the dusk when unexpectedly she sees a mermaid. Nonetheless, the extreme next second, the mermaid abruptly vanishes. Aisha then, at that point, goes to Amy's apartment complex, where she sees Malik with his 5-year-old child, Priest. Cleric tells her that his dad likes her. Presently, a couple of additional days pass like this. In the meantime, Aisha over and over calls her cousin to converse with her child, yet Maria doesn't get her call. Because of this, she is presently extremely disturbed. At some point, Malik welcomes her to his home to meet his grandma, Kathleen. She sees an image of a mermaid on the wall, an understanding of mom water, as Kathleen makes sense of it. Some accept that the mermaids draw with commitments of sexuality, cash, and fruitfulness. Notwithstanding, they are viewed as risky, unusual, and ephemeral. Aisha says that she feels like she has seen a mermaid, alluding to the very mermaid scene that happened before. Kathleen asks, "What's the name of your child?" Aisha is very stunned, as she had not even informed Malik concerning her child recently. How did his grandma come to be familiar with it? Before she can ask anything, Malik shows up and requests that she go with him to supper. While eating, Aisha gets some information about his grandma. He tells her that she is brought into the world with the capacity to see as a priestess. Malik shares about his mom, referencing that she passed on from sickness when he was a youngster. Aisha additionally uncovers that her mom kicked the bucket when she was 12 years of age. Both become profound. After supper, Aisha gets serious about her child, and they go to Aisha's home, where they draw nearer. The next day, Aisha takes Rose to play in the park. While there, she unexpectedly sees her son Lamin. She starts moving towards her son, leaving Rose playing. Suddenly, a woman arrives and scolds Aisha, claiming that Rose had left the park. When Aisha looks back, Lamin is nowhere to be seen. She tells Rose the bedtime story of Nancy the spider and then asks her, "Why did you leave the park today?" Rose responds that a Nancy told her to do so. "I understand that the concept of mermaid and the Nancy spider might not be clear at this point, but it will become evident in the next scene." When Aisha is putting Rose to sleep, a large spider's shadow is seen on the nearby wall. Aisha ignores it and goes to talk to Adam. Tearfully, she tells Adam that Amy has not paid her for the last several months, preventing her from bringing her son to America. Aisha declares that if she is not paid, she will leave the job. Adam tries to kiss her after giving her some money, but she bites him. He apologizes, and she leaves, revealing his questionable character. The next day, we see Aisha in a swimming pool, attending Rose's swimming class. As soon as she takes a dip in the pool, she enters a different world where mommy water haunts her, and she gets visions of her son. However, she regains consciousness and learns that she had actually fainted. Disturbed by these visions, she goes to meet Malik's grandmother and shares details about Anansi spiders, dreams, and mommy's visions. Kathleen explains to her that Anansi spider and mommy water represent the odds and the fight for survival. If these two spirits are visible to her, it means they want to warn her, something about blood, an eye for an eye, and a desire for rebirth to persist. Good and evil are not easily defined, Kathleen adds. Aisha becomes confused about the message these spirits are trying to convey. In the next scene, Aisha feeds Rose her usual spicy food. Amy arrives and angrily confronts Aisha for feeding Rose spicy food, criticizing her for not having anything in the fridge. Aisha retorts, mentioning that she has been using her own money to feed Rose, for which Amy has not yet paid her. Amy instructs Aisha to stay overnight and do overtime the next day, promising to pay all her money afterward. That night, Aisha is with Malik. She feels that many snakes have come onto her bed, leading her to tears. However, it turns out to be her nightmare, and Malik comforts her. The next day, she stays overnight at Amy's house. As she closes her eyes to sleep, she feels that water surrounds her bed, and suddenly her face gets covered with a cloth, causing her to suffocate. She struggles to remove the cloth and wakes up, realizing it was another nightmare. In the next scene, we see that Aisha is filling water in the bathtub to bathe Rose. Suddenly, Rose disappears, prompting Aisha to search the entire house. She hears strange voices, including Rose asking for help. Thinking that someone may have entered the house, Aisha grabs a knife and starts searching for Rose. While searching, she falls into the bathroom, feeling a black shadow pulling her into the bathtub. About to attack inside the bathtub with a knife to save herself, she hears a voice calling her name. Turning around, she carefully sees Rose inside the bathtub. Aisha was on the verge of unintentionally harming Rose, but a voice stopped her. She then brings Rose to bed to put her to sleep. Rose says, "Who made you do it?" "He's jealous." Aisha asks, "Who?" Rose lies, saying, "Nancy told me that he's jealous of her." Shocked, Aisha asks, "Who told you all this?" Rose replies, "And Nancy told me that it's my fault." That same night, Aisha receives a voice message from Maria, explaining that her mother was unwell, and she was busy taking care of her, which is why she couldn't answer the call. However, she promises to call Aisha soon. The next morning, Adam gives all the remaining money to Aisha, with which she goes to the bank. She is very happy because now she will be able to bring her son to America. Finally, that day comes, and she eagerly waits for her son at the airport with Malik. However, when her son doesn't arrive even after a long time, she comes out of the airport upset. There, she sees Maria standing alone. Angrily, she asks, "Where is her son?" Maria, too, cries and tells her that one day she took Lamin to the beach where the sea waves were very strong. In the midst of those waves, it is not known how he got lost. But she did not have the courage to tell this, and that's why she was not picking up her call. Now, you must have understood the meaning of Aisha's nightmare here, why she used to dream of the sea, her suffocation, and all of these things. It meant that her son had drowned, symbolizing the deep connection between mother and son. Just like her, she was feeling these things. It was nothing but a hint to her about the drowning of her son. In my opinion, this is a very sad moment and also a very significant turning point in this movie. Hearing all these things, she feels a great shock because Lamin was the only support in her life. She had been working hard for so many days, and now he is no more. She gets so depressed by Lamin's news that she decides to end her life. She goes for a walk, intending to drown herself in the Hudson River. As soon as she goes into the water, she sees Lamin on the top. Mommy Water then saves her from drowning. Malik brings her home, and Aisha learns that she is pregnant. She gets a new reason to live. We then see the scene after 9 months when she gives birth to a child who looks exactly like Lamin. With this, the movie ends at this point. Now, let's first talk about Anansi Spider and Mommy Water here. According to African mythology, Mommy Water and Anansi Spider appear only to those who are oppressed. As we all know, Aisha had faced harassment since childhood, even on the job, and was troubled for not getting paid on time. These spirits, urban legends, were trying to warn her about Lamin's drowning, and that she would not be able to save him. A theory here also suggests that her son had drowned in water, and because of the mother-son connection, she also started having dreams of drowning. She was saddened by not being able to meet her son, and also she was not getting paid on time. The sightings of these urban legends turned out to be true because Rose also felt and saw the same things. Anansi Spider was taking Rose away from Aisha so that she could gather information about her son's well-being, as she had not talked to him for a long time. When Lamin drowned in water, his soul became very angry with Aisha for taking care of another child instead of him. This resentment led the spirit to want Rose killed by Aisha. However, Mommy Water prevented this from happening. In the end, you must have seen that Aisha was going to kill herself. Mommy Water, in this context, creates a cycle of both life and death. I believe that if she was not pregnant, Mommy Water would not have saved her. If you are wondering how Rose and Anansi Spider were communicating, it's a common portrayal in movies that spirits often communicate with small children. Anansi conveyed Lamin's feelings to Aisha through Rose, but she could not understand it. In the end, when Aisha decided to end her life, Mommy Water saved her underwater because Lamin is about to be reborn as Aisha's second child. I mentioned earlier that Mommy Water symbolizes rebirth, and the child's face is exactly like Lamin's. Another point proven here is that Malik's grandmother, Kathleen, was right. Either they want an eye for an eye or a rebirth. The story also touches on the challenges faced by immigrants, highlighting the difficulties they endure. These are some of my theories, and I hope you enjoyed this story. Thank you for watching. Thanks for watching Real Recapped. Please hit the subscribe button so you can get notified for more videos like this.